I personally can never understand people that party all the time. I feel like those people are trying to escape something. Just like people who smoke all the time, drink all the time. I don't care if it's weed or not. I don't know why weed smokers are always trying to convince themselves that they don't have a problem. If you're literally smoking weed every day, there's something wrong with you. I don't give a fuck. Okay, you're trying to escape something. That's another unpopular opinion. There's no reason that you're telling me you have to be high all day, every day. You're escaping something. Just like people who drink all day. Just like people who have to have sex all day. All of y'all have a problem and you need help. I said what I said. It's okay. We all have problems. We just all have to have a talk about it. We all have to have some time to admit it. Sigh. Unpopular opinions video. I've not done one of these in probably like 9, 10, too many months, y'all. My last one was literally in January, and then I took like a month long break, so I think I'm genuinely overdue. So these are the unpopular opinions that's gonna piss y'all off, so get your tea, get your snacks, get airline, because I'm here to make y'all mad per usual. Every single time I make one of these, I lose so many subscribers, and then like there's people like recording this shit and getting mad and dragging me on Twitter. Like, I give a fuck. Like, to be honest, I said what I said. So let's commence now, shall we? Now, my first unpopular opinion is working a 9-to-5 is not that fucking bad. Now, the thing is, I've always been one of those people that maintain that I do not want to work for anyone. Okay, I remember I was literally like maybe 13 and I literally always knew I wanted to work in media. I didn't know what type of media yet, but I knew I always wanted to work in media. I honestly really always wanted to work in print. Then it became film. Then it became psychology. And then I was like, okay, let's do media and psychology. And I was like, oh my God, I wanna be like Dr. Phil. And then I was like, you know what? I'm gonna have to pick between psychology and media. And when I got to high school, like, I really had to pick. And then I just decided to go into media because I was like, oh my God, psychology, too much reading, too much books. And then I remember my dad had asked me, like when I was really young, I had to be like 12. He was like, what do you wanna do when you get older? I was like, I don't wanna work for anyone. And he was like, well, he didn't say it like that, but dramatic effect.
That's impossible. Everyone works for someone.
I was like, nigga, watch me. I didn't say nigga, but you guys get the point. It's funny because look at me now.
2021, I ain't working for us all.
I mean, I do have a part-time, but for the most part, YouTube is my full-time job. I only work a part-time because they begged me to come back after I quit. Like, I literally visited one day and they're like, you wanna come back? And I'm like, no. And they're like, you can work from home. It will give you a raise. And I'm like, I don't wanna come back. And they're like, okay, you start next week. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I child. But it's also in media as well. I just always knew that I had a passion to be in media. So I do YouTube full-time and I work in radio sales. Like, I love media. YouTube kind of fell in my lap. I never really wanted to be like a YouTuber, but I knew that whatever it was that I wanted to do, I wanted to be in social media. But one thing that they never tell you about social media is the fucking taxes, and that has to be the worst thing. The taxes, the fluctuating income, and the lack of like an IRA, a 401k, and all the things that a job gives you. A 9-to-5 gives you the most security when it comes to your future, and it really is annoying that a lot of people are out here selling these courses and all this extra shit telling you that, like,
oh my God, you're gonna be a millionaire, you're gonna be a
bullshit. Okay, I do consultations, right? I teach people how to be YouTubers and how to grow their social media following and all of that. You guys are free to go down below and schedule a consultation with me and all of that. I will definitely help you guys. But one thing I will never do is sell you guys a dream and tell you guys you're gonna get 1 million followers and make 6 figures in a month and all. Like, I would never do that because it's just not realistic and it's just not true. And not only that, it's just a lot harder than a lot of people make it seem. I didn't go full time till about 2018 or 19. Yeah, I made a video about like why everyone wants to be an influencer or something like that. A lot of people thought I was like a dream crusher because I was like, why the hell everyone want to be a YouTuber when like y'all just want to be a YouTuber or an influencer because everyone's doing it. Like, a lot of y'all, that's not your dream. Y'all just think it's easy money and you just want to do it because everyone's doing it. And that's not what I meant. My thing is, a lot of you, that's not your true dream. You know, we still need astronauts, we still need scientists, we still need doctors. It's true and it's fact. Not only is it not realistic to be an influencer, because a lot of people don't have the personality, don't have the dream, don't have the drive, don't have the motivation, but it's just not a sound thing to rely on. When you have a 9-to-5, you only have to work 9-to-5, y'all. Like, when you're an influencer, you work it all fucking day, bruh. I literally be 1 o'clock in the morning editing sometimes. Bro, it be 3 o'clock in the morning, I'm answering emails. Like, you never fucking sleep. Like, you literally always working. Like, I be at the doctor's office writing fucking captions. I literally be on a plane editing a video. Like, it's nonstop grind. And it's not for everyone. Like, a lot of people think that all YouTubers and influencers do is take pictures and, you know, record videos. But in actuality, there's a lot to this. There's a lot that goes into making videos and recording and, you know, whatever it is. And what's even worse is you're probably not gonna get any sponsors. You have to rely on, you know, YouTube revenue, which you're probably not gonna make any money for years. A lot of people think that as soon as you become a YouTuber, you're gonna make millions of dollars. I don't know why people keep fucking telling people that shit. It's so sad how people be selling y'all these dreams and then people quit. Oh my God. Like, if I really were to probably sit here and tell you guys you're gonna make 6 figures in like a month, then I'd probably be making so much more money with Media Hustle, but I would never do that to you guys. Moving on. My next unpopular opinion is wedges is ugly. Yes, heel wedges is ugly. I mean, I wear heels a lot. Like, I wear heels every day. Like, I be stunting, I be flexing, I'm cute as hell. Like, I love me some heels, and I could say wedges. I probably only owned like maybe 3 wedges in my entire life, and I could say they were the most ugliest things I've ever owned. I never liked the way they looked on anyone's feet, including mine. And I can say that when other people wear them, I feel like they look just as hideous. They need to be destroyed, burned, buried, deceased, okay? Canceling people for their political opinions is immature as fuck. I feel like ever since Trump, people have really shown their true colors. I personally don't even understand why people are so damn hung up on people's political opinions. Like, I understand people feel so strongly about politics, but it's like, to not be friends with someone over who they voted for, I think it's just childish. People should respect people's opinions and respect why people voted for certain people. If anything, I feel like people should kind of ask their friends, why did you vote for this person? Politics is a deep-rooted thing, right? I feel like if you grew up in a certain neighborhood, or you have a certain business venture, or, you know, you are a certain person from a certain type of neighborhood, or, you know, like, maybe you have a medical condition, whatever the case may be, that is what's gonna prompt you to vote for a certain person or not vote at all, whatever the case may be. I feel like it's just really, like, insensitive and immature to literally be like, oh, this person voted for this person, I'm not gonna fucking talk to you. It's just fucked up. Whatever. Baby style, you know, those old videos of people styling baby's hair, like, especially, like, in the Black community, like, them little baby styling videos where the baby can't even hold their head up, it's strange. I don't like it. It actually kind of makes me want to vomit. I'm sorry. Actually, I'm not. Why do y'all do that? What is the fascination of literally brushing a baby's scalp? Like, y'all literally be doing baby hair tutorials with babies that got less hair than a baby doll. These kids be really looking worse than they look trying to take a little poop when y'all be trying to put these little ass babies' heads in a fucking ponytail. Baby hair tutorials gotta go. The baby looks stressed, I'm stressed. Like, I think everybody's stressed in the situation. Hip hop needs to be destroyed. Rap, all of that, okay? All music that is basically consumed by the grander Black community has to be destroyed and redone, because we have fucked it up and all the grandfathers and godfathers of hip hop are rolling in their graves right now. Wait, a lot of them are still alive. You guys get the point. It's horrible. I can't even listen to a majority of it anymore. It just doesn't interest me, and I haven't even done it consciously. A lot of it, I just stopped consuming. Like, I still have my playlists and stuff, but, like, I don't listen to a lot of it. I listen to a lot of Haitian music now. Music is just dying, like, Jesus Christ. And to follow that, hip hop and rap is definitely black-faced. I've actually talked about this before. Surely a lot of the rappers in hip hop, honestly, 90% of them, 99.9% of them are Black, right? But on the back end, they're all white. The producers, the songwriters, the managers, they're all Caucasian. And that's problematic. And that's why I said it needs to be destroyed and start over. There's no reason why a culture that was made by us and for us is dominated by white people. And I think that is the sheer problem here, because the propaganda still is and for destroying the Black community. And there needs to be something done about this. And I feel like Black people are feeding into this without knowing and understanding that we are literally feeding into our own demise. Girlfriends is the most boring show on earth. I don't know who the fuck watches it, why the fuck they watch it. All it does is put me to sleep. I watch too many episodes to literally not understand what the fuck the point of the show is. Ketchup is disgusting as hell. I would not eat ketchup unless it's mixed with hot sauce or mayonnaise. I love it. Who likes ketchonaise or mayo ketchup? I love it. Oh my god. I like very strange combinations, and there's literally only but so many things that I will eat that I don't like the base of, or vice versa. Like, I hate ketchup, but I'll eat a tomato. Like, no tomorrow. I'll eat a tomato like an apple. Okay, I hate carrots, but I love carrot juice. I like avocados, but I don't like guacamole. Like, I'm strange, okay? Frosted sugar cookies from the supermarket is disgusting. And if you eat that, you should be arrested. People who eat soggy cereal should also be arrested. There's something wrong with you. So my dad should be in jail. Like, oof, child, that shit gotta be crunchy. You gotta eat it fat. Dark chocolate is better than milk chocolate. Milk chocolate tastes artificial as fuck. I don't understand people who eat milk chocolate whatsoever. Gin is the most superior light liquor ever. Period. Barbecue is the most overrated sauce ever. Honey mustard is where it's at. Cyberbullying only exists online. Turn your phone off. Now, unless you're being cyberbullied by people you have to see in real life, that's a whole nother story. But like, if you're literally getting dragged on the shade room, turn your phone off. Doesn't exist. Like, in retrospect, if you're literally being bothered by people you don't know, there's literally something going on in your psyche. You're not gonna see these people. They don't know where you live. They don't know who you are. And they're literally putting comments on your social media. Quick fix is remove yourself from the situation. Wearing designer doesn't mean you can dress. Wearing and owning designer don't mean you rich. First of all, DH Gate is the fucking GOAT. I be seeing people out here flexing their little DH Gate online. I'm like, what? So I don't have to go to Louis Vuitton? Bitch, yo, DH Gate got motherfuckers looking swaggy. DH Gate really out here putting people on. And a lot of people who really do have real designer or whatever the case may be will literally have a Gucci shirt on with like a Fendi belt, but then they have True Religion pants, and then they'll couple it with like, you know, some Gucci shoes, and they think they swagged out, and they don't, the colors don't match, the patterns don't match, they just look all types of goofy. And it's like, boy, like, you got no money and you can't dress, like, just tap out because you look a mess. Stop. Watching movies at home is better. I don't know if it's because of COVID, but like, I personally do not think I will ever go back to the movies. Like, it was overpriced. The snacks and the food was never that good. But like, I just like being laid up with bae and just like chilling and, you know, having stage lay on my stomach and just
watching a nice little movie on Netflix.
Like, the only process I liked about going to the movies was getting cute. I don't know, comment down below. Like, do you like the experience of going to the movies? Like, do you care after COVID? Because like, personally, I am not looking forward to ever going back to the movies unless it's a dine-in theater. Those were nice. Those, but even at that, I don't really care. Love is not a choice. Relationships are a choice. You cannot help who you fall in love with, but you can choose who you get in a relationship with. I know a lot of people like to say love is a choice, but not necessarily. You can't help who you fall in love with. You can't help how you feel about anyone, realistically, right? So if you love someone, you know, you can't just be like, I don't love them anymore, let me turn it off. But if you go and you pursue that relationship, that's on your ass. And I feel the same way about sexuality. At the end of the day, you can't help that you like men or you like women or whatever the case may be, or you know, that you're asexual or pansexual or whatever. But the lifestyle that you choose to live is your choice. If you choose to live in your truth or you choose not to, that is your choice. I feel like people who choose to live in their lifestyle are so brave, and I commend y'all, okay? Whether you're straight, whether you're not, whatever the case may be, hats off to y'all. Clubbing regularly is not attractive, okay? It's just not. If I'm in the club literally once every 3 months and I see you there every 3 months, that means you're always in the fucking club. There's no way that I'm just conveniently catching you every time I'm there and I'm only there every 3 months. To be honest, I don't care if you're male or female. There's something genuinely wrong with that. That means you might have to go to club rehab. Is that a thing? Party rehab? There's something wrong with it. I personally can never understand people that party all the time. I feel like those people are trying to escape something. Just like people who smoke all the time, drink all the time. I don't care if it's weed or not. I don't know why weed smokers are always trying to convince themselves that they don't have a problem. If you're literally smoking weed every day, there's something wrong with you. I don't give a fuck. Okay, you're trying to escape something. That's another unpopular opinion. There's no reason that you're telling me you have to be high all day, every day. You're escaping something. Just like people who drink all day. Just like people who have to have sex all day. All of y'all have a problem and you need help. I said what I said. It's okay. We all have problems. We just all have to have a talk about it. We all have to have some time to admit it. Sigh. Could we talk about how much money that is? Clubbing all day, smoking all day, drinking all day, fucking all day. That's a lot of condoms. I'm hoping you pretend to yourself. Like, that's just so much. It's just too much. Like, oh my God. I don't know. Do y'all. Mangoes are the most superior fruit, period. I don't want to hear about what your favorite fruit is because mangoes are superior. All right. That's it for this video. Let me know down in the comment section below. What unpopular opinions did you agree with? What unpopular opinions did you not agree with? You hate me yet? I don't give a fuck. You love me yet? Yes, I give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I give a fuck. Like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!